My name is Mahi Sanghavi and I am from Lonas of Mumbai. My story is called The Mysterious Woodlands. This is a story about a girl who decides to explore a forest no one has ever plucked up the courage to explore. Read on to find out what happens next. The night belonged to the howling winds as the sky was kissed by moist, rain-laden clouds. The Orion Forest, also known as the Mysterious Woodlands, was cocooned by the velvet of the night. Not a single soul had plucked up the courage to explore the jungle. I, on the other hand, wanted to leave no stone unturned of the forest. I wanted to be the first one to unveil all of its secrets. As I entered the forest, the sky threatened to break into a downpour. The mysterious... As Nelson Mandela once said, it always seems impossible until it is done. I was determined to cross the woodlands, though it seemed doubtful to do it and come back in one piece. The jungle seemed like something out of a horror movie. Thick trees towered above me like 12-foot tall giants. Something was seemingly wrong about this place. I was sure of it, and I was determined to uncover it. The wilderness was full of danger lurking behind. I was sure of it. Suddenly, the delirious dance of the rain on the bed of the jungle began its performance. I put on my emerald green raincoat and started walking. I took every step with caution, careful not to disturb the terrifying beasts that hid in the confining branches. A little while later, I heard a muffled voice muttering, "She must die. I will make sure that she dies in this jungle itself. Or my name is Trunchak the Evil." I froze dead in my tracks. So, the legend of Trunchak the Evil was true. Many people believed that once a young man got lost in the forest. He was known as Trunchak the Great. He ventured forward, unaware of the danger lurking behind him that had an appetite for fresh bones and blood. The werewolf bit him severely in his ankle, thigh, and then lunged for his heart. Though the werewolf devoured his heart, Trunchak didn't die. Blood simply drained out of his body, making a delectable dish for the werewolf. He hobbled on while devilry started dancing in his veins, and his mind churned with nasty ideas for the death of mortals. Now the legend was proven true. Trunchak the Evil was aiming at me. I came back to my senses and started to run. But I could only go deeper into the jungle as the outskirts were monitored by Trunchak. As I ran deeper into the jungle, I met Trunchak the Evil about as unexpectedly as I could have felt. He wore a mustard yellow tunic, which was as different from a jungle as sunny yellow is from ditch water brown. He wore a supposedly angelic expression, though his eyes glowed menacingly. He glared at me like a wolf would to its prey. Suddenly, he lunged at me as fast as lightning, and for a split second, I saw a wolf in him. As if he knew what I was thinking, he transformed into a fierce wolf. The deadly creature sitting on top of me raised its paw as if to slash me and feast upon my blood. His claws glowed in the silvery moonlight. Just then, the first rays of dawn peeked out of the horizon and reaching out for us. When the shiny golden rays touched the werewolf, the demonic werewolf sitting on top of me was reduced to nothing. I jumped up and dashed back home, delighted as well as fascinated to think that the jungle had kept its promise, truly making it a mysterious woodland. Thank you.